I think you should read this first.
Oh, yeah, I didn't know you were counting, sir.
Well, whatever. This is the Brown Act says that we cannot lengthen we're not actually adding an extra year to each board member's term.
That's not the issue.
Well, that's...
That's not the issue.
What is the issue?
The issue is the notification. The notification is in violation of the Brown Act.
The notification of the meeting? The notification of the meeting. Really?
The notification of the meeting.
So what that would effectively mean is no actions taken tonight. Or whatever actions taken tonight can be overturned.
Well,
what are we talking about?
The Brown Act states that every special meeting, the legislative body should provide the public with an opportunity to address the body on any item described in the notice before or during consideration of that item. The Brown Act also states that the special meeting notice shall describe the public's rights to so comment. That's in violation.
Well, we're having an open meeting. We're going to give you the opportunity to address the board regarding the resolutions.
That's because there are no non-agenda items for the public to comment
no,
on.
It doesn't it, mean...
We do not have to explicitly state
the
anything.
The Brown Act, you're violating the Brown Act. Go ahead and have the meeting if you want to. I'm going to put in a violation. Go ahead.
Can I just say something? Like,
read the Brown Act. The Brown Act says you're supposed to notify the public that they have the opportunity to speak, and you don't have any of that on the agenda.
But this is a public meeting held in a public forum, and each agenda item we discuss every time on... But work with me here, Linda. Think about a regular agenda. In addition to the section public comment on non-agenda items, each agenda item has time when public is allowed to speak.
I'm not
this
talking about regular board meetings.
This time is not specifically listed under each item on the agenda.
I'm not talking about regular board meetings. I'm talking
the
about
same,
this
don't interrupt me, please.
Special
let me
fix,
board let me finish. Okay. The same way each item has not a special subsection for public comment, this item also doesn't have a special subsection for public comment. It is a matter of course that during a public meeting, public has the right to comment and will so during this meeting.
Mm-hmm. Do you have anything to add?
No, I agree with you.
Well, it states that the special meeting notice shall describe the public's right to so comment. So the agenda doesn't have a specific notice to describe the public's right to comment.
What's worse than that? Did you take action? She files a Brown Act violation and the attorney can overturn it or not? What do you postpone the meeting?
We're not postponing the meeting.
Mr. President?
Sure.
I'm confused. Yes, I'm hearing at least two different things coming from that direction. Is the issue the public notice announcing the meeting, or is it the published agenda for the meeting? That's the
I think it's the public notice expressing the rights of the public to speak at the meeting.
There is no specific agenda line item that says public comment.
No, I understand that, and I don't know why it would have to be a separate item. And I didn't bring the notice, so I don't have it in front of me. But I assume, as I recall, it noticed the meeting and said what we were going to do. Is the issue is it doesn't say, and the public will have the opportunity to comment?
That seems to be the crux of the matter.
But it, and is that different from a regular meeting where we don't have that said either? There's just the open time for non-agenda items. There's nothing said in our normal procedure about agenda items.
Well,
we just do it.
Yeah, and it says, the Brown Act states that every special meeting, the legislative body, I guess that would be us, shall provide the public with an opportunity to address the body on any item described in the notice before or during that item. So we're going to call the resolution. Do I have to read the resolution? Is that something that should be done?
The whole thing.
Resolution number 2017.
Can I interrupt just for a second?
Well, let me read this first.
Okay, but typically there's public comment on every public meeting. Also a Brown Act. So I'm actually with you on this, but I just want to make sure we follow the procedure.
Well, that's what I'm trying to do. I'm trying to bring this resolution up. We're going to make a motion to adopt. We'll discuss it, and then we'll open it up to the public, just like
it's
we would do.
It's not the agenda. It's a Brown Act violation.
It's great. Not the agenda.
Mr. President, so far we've had the public hijacking this meeting. I would suggest
so
that you get on with the agenda.
Okay, well.
From the actual Brown Act, first I have for you, please. From section 549.54.3, subsection A, which is what it says is being quoted here. Every notice for a special meeting shall provide an opportunity for members of the public to directly address the legislative body concerning any item that has been described in the notice for the meeting before or during consideration of that item.
That's what we're doing right now,
next
I
sentence.
Believe. And then
next sentence is subsection B -1. The legislative body of a local agency may adopt reasonable regulations to ensure that the intent of subdivision A is carried out, including but not limited to regulations limiting the total amount of time allocated for public testimony on particular issues and for each individual speaker. I do not see anywhere in here where it
says... Are you reading the Brown Act, or are you reading somebody else's description?
No, I'm reading from leadinfo.legislature.california.gov. I'm reading the government statute.
But you're not a lawyer. This is
That's
the problem. None of us are lawyers. And so I think we're all flying a little bit blind with our interpretation.
No, I think the interpretation is, I'm going to read this. We're going to bring up a motion to either adopt or not. And then we're going to discuss it as a board, and then we're going to open it up to the public, just like we would do at any agenda item, following the Brown Act as it's written. Resolution of the Board of Directors of the Marinwood Community Services District requiring even-numbered year elections for the Board of Directors. Do I hear a motion?
So moved. Second.
Shall we discuss this openly? Hold on.
Sure. I gave you a fairly detailed memo on other pieces of information that I think you guys should be aware of as you go through, as well as relevant statutes, government codes. Ultimately, the CSD is governed by Government Code Section 61000, which is also commonly known and cited as Community Services District Law. Within Government Code Section 61000, you have Government Code Section 61042 that explicitly states that directors are elected to four-year terms. There is no provision within the Code 61000 that states for three-year or five-year terms, with the exception of when a vacancy occurs and somebody could possibly be elected to a two-year term. The 61000 also states in Government Code Section 61008 that directors may require to move to even-numbered year elections for governing body members in accordance with Election Code 10404. Election Code Section 10404 is specific to special districts. Within that code is Section 10404, subsection I, that states that upon a motion and a resolution, terms can be, will be extended by a period not to exceed December 31st of the year following when they would have normally expired. There is nothing within there that allows you to shorten the terms. They can only be extended. This is different from a city, which would follow Election Code 10403.5 that clearly states increase or decrease by a period not to exceed 12 months. I've also run this through the Elections Department. Their interpretation is the same as mine. In speaking with the Elections Department, there is an exception to this rule for districts who have less than a 25% decrease in voter turnout from odd number year elections to even number year elections. It is their interpretation that there is no district territory within the County of Marin that qualifies for this exception. And that's pretty much it. So if approved, this resolution, you will be postponing your 2017 election. You will be moving it to 2018. All board terms will be extended by 1 year. If not approved, you will have the 2017 election as currently planned. The district will have to submit a plan by January 1st, 2018 on how you will migrate to even years. You can then pass a similar resolution after the 2017 election that would extend terms by 1 year. You can wait until after the 2019 election and then extend terms by 1 year. And regardless, at some point, terms will be extended by 1 year, and you will have people who are elected to a four-year term serving a five-year term by board resolution. You are going to be mandated by the state through SB 415 to do this by the year 2022. And in further conversation with the Elections Department, as of today, 24 local governments in Marin County have moved off of the 2017 election and have moved to 2018.
So if I get this correct, then after the 2018 and the 2020, we're back to four-year periods.
Correct. Your 2018 election, you'll be electing a four-year person, and your 2020 election, you'll be electing a four-year person.
And no matter what we do now or wait till 2022?
You will always be electing a four-year term at some point, a sitting board.
Somewhere along the line, it has to go to a five. Okay. So it's better to get it over with now.
Well, that's your decision.
Yeah. Well, that's how I feel.
So. And if we do not, excuse me for interrupting.
Go ahead.
If we do not do this, it's very likely that we'll be spending somewhere in the neighborhood of $18,000 to foot the bill for the election in 2017. Is that close to reality?
If not more, yes. Mm-hmm. Your 2015 election cost just under $10,000 for 2015. They're anticipating a conservative estimate of at least 100% increase in cost due to how fewer jurisdictions are going to be on the ballot.
Okay.
I kind of described the cost base.
Yeah, I saw that, yeah. It's kind of, what's the point of spending money when we don't have it?
And to fail to do this by 2022 would open the district to lawsuits.
Correct?
Yep. And just to be perfectly clear, this ordinance is known as the California Voter Participation Rights Act. This is in defense of the voters, okay? This is to make sure that by aligning ourselves with state, the state initiatives and the state ballots, that we get a greater voter turnout when we have our elections. So, just to put it in context.
Anybody else?
Earth.
It seems like the state, our state government had a great idea, and there's no question it will save money. And it may increase voter turnout, but the downside is it extends all the terms by a year. That you know, I feel a little funny about, because, you know, while I was appointed to the board, you folks were elected mm-hmm. to a four-year term. Right. And I realize that there's great monetary value in getting another year for all of us. But,
yeah.
but, you know, while I'm in favor of doing this now purely from the standpoint of why waste the money on an odd year election, I do agree to some respect that it's sort of taking some of the, what's the right word, authority of the voter away, really and truly. But I don't know a solution to it other than doing it, and at least we save the money.
Irv, I couldn't agree with you more. Luckily, we are not in a position where these directorship positions are a compensated position. If I were to extend my salary for a year, I wouldn't feel very uncomfortable doing this. Fortunately, with such generous compensation that we receive, there is no, you know, financial funny business going on. Is it uncomfortable and bizarre to be in a position of extending your own term? Yes, I'd much rather not do it. But given the opportunity to save district $20,000, I'd much rather spend this money on the firefighter's kitchen that we need to redo because of mold.
Go. One other thing. Yeah, I just like to mention that when those of us who were elected ran for this office, we were signing up for a four-year term. That does not, as we have seen evidence of in the not too distant past, that does not preclude us from resigning that position. There's nothing that says we're forced to serve that term. However, I will point out also that it's very likely that there are citizens in our neighborhood, our community, who might take a little bit different attitude towards a three-year term, saying, oh, we elected you for a four-year term, and you're just deciding you're not going to live up to that, are you? So, I mean, there are different points of view,
yes.
And I think we should recognize that.
Well, I'll open it up to the public if we have
anyone else. So there was two opportunities to speak. First, at the beginning of the meeting, on any subject, this is Brown Act, of concern to the public, okay? And I'd like to speak to that. Secondly, on the issue. So that's why I was trying to stop you before you open that up. But nevertheless, I'm going to take my initial comments first, and I guess allow Linda to speak, and then I'll make the commentary here. I'm glad to see everyone salute the flag, and because we owe our allegiance to the Republic and democracy. And this, what you're about to undertake is a very serious issue, and it will, I mean, it basically looks like it's self-dealing. Secondly, the information that you have been provided is incomplete to my research, and in fact, Eric made one statement today about the elections code, or that no special district qualifies. And according to my research, there are a lot. We have very high voter turnout here in Marin, so I believe we're exempt from this whole process. Third, you're doing a special meeting here. It's unnecessary. We don't have to comply to this until 2022. So to somehow do this quickly, slam it down in 10 minutes is completely wrong. And I hope you take the gravity about what you're gonna do. Now the other thing is, research, LA County is objecting to this. The law may change by the end of 2017, but that's all I have to say for right now. And I guess I'll let, if Linda, are you going to speak? Or?
Yeah, I'm only going to say one thing.
Okay, and then I'll make my other remarks.
My comment is that
we elected these people for 4 years, and some people may not want these particular board members on an extra year. And those particular voters may want to vote in someone else other than you five people after 4 years. So if we don't have a choice of voting in somebody else to replace the two people in 4 years and then the two people or the three people after that, it's I just think it's an injustice to the voters. That's all.
Okay. So next comments. So I provided in this letter the analysis provided to the city of San Rafael, which considered this the other night. They all were concerned. They actually didn't act on it the other night. They were concerned of how the public would react, how other communities would react in Marin. And so although I think most of them favored the five-year term, it wasn't a done deal. In fact, the clerk said most cities in California are going with three-year terms. Now, I find it very curious that we have a law that says you can't adjust terms downward, but you can adjust them upwards. I think that is something that could possibly be challenged. It's legally inconsistent. It's logically inconsistent. There really is only one option. You can choose three-year terms, you can choose five-year terms. There's two ways you can do it. But the bottom line is if you go to three, if you have an election this November for 3 years, and then the next election is for 3 years, you will sync up by 2022, you'll meet the requirements of the law, and the only incremental cost is the cost of that fall election. And I'm sorry to say, you may think it's a waste of money. I value my vote. I know other people's value their vote, and I think, you know, take a look at it. This is the stuff of despots when they say, I'm president, you know, whenever, you know, extending your terms. It's not the way things are done in a democracy. And given the fact that we have a director who has ignored three California records requests, there are some, and in blatant violation of the law, there's other issues as well. I think, you know, the scrutiny that could come down on the board could be a little uncomfortable, and this act really only solidifies a bad taste in the public's mouth. So I would just say, I think Irv, you have the right instinct here. Let's stay on the side of the voters, and I hope each one of you will consider it and not dismiss it as an annoyance, but to embrace the full concept of democracy. You were elected to 4 years. I think you should have 4 years. I'm sorry that we have this law, but the only fair way to do it for the public is to reduce it to three-year terms. The good news is, if you want to run again, you're all incumbents, so you have that advantage. So thank you.
Thank you. Could you refresh me the reasoning? There's a difference between city and special districts, is there not, in this
city
law?
City follows municipal code.
Follows
it. We follow what's known as community services district law.
Right.
Which is a different section of government.
And we're not able to hold to the three-year term. Okay. I wanted to make that clear. That's the law according to special districts.
None of us are lawyers, so I'm just saying that if you have questions, if there's a question on it, it probably should be vetted before you make a decision, the wrong decision.
It's special district. That's where we fall under special district. We don't follow the same law that the cities do or the county.
I do.
Okay.
Can I make one more statement?
Go for it.
Without relinquishing any level of attorney-client privilege, this resolution was vetted by council.
Okay. Irv?
Apparently, at least LA County is looking to change the law or add to it or amend it or something, would there, I think we're sort of almost, from a fiscal standpoint, forced to adopting this resolution, or we're just going to waste a bunch of money. But could we add to it some kind of a provision that if the law changes before we would normally get on with the 2017 election, that we could revert back or reconsider or whatever?
You cannot add that to this resolution simply because it wasn't posted with that provision. However, you can rescind it at a later date.
Well, I don't know what LA County would have anything to do with special districts, though.
They have special districts down there.
They have special districts, but the county is totally different.
They will be appealing to Sacramento to amend the law. Trust me, I looked at this. Throughout the state, this is causing some problems, and so they may try to amend it and fix some of the problems, because people don't like appointing themselves for 5 years. It just doesn't make sense.
Well,
can I ask a question?
Go for it.
Did County Council vet this with the information that you just read at the beginning of the meeting about cities and special districts being different? Did they know that information when they vetted it?
It's the law, I assume.
So.
You know how the law is. It's subject to interpretation.
I did not ask them specific if they are familiar with the differences between CSD law and municipal code.
So that didn't play into the decision at all?
No.
Okay. Thank you.
No, we don't follow municipal code. We follow CSD law.
It's a county council.
Right. But you don't follow other laws.
So, should we put that additional resolution in or call for a vote?
I think call for a vote because we can always deal with it later.
I was satisfied with Eric's answer that we could always rescind this if the law changes.
All right.
Why is it rushed tonight, though?
There's a deadline for the 2017 election. If we don't declare this before Friday, we will have no choice except for to participate in the 2017 election.
Correct.
People have been voting on this since the fall of last year. I don't know why we had to do a last-minute meeting like this. I guess it just kind of passed notice, but I think
we'll call for a vote then. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Aye. Opposed?
Aye.
Okay, well, I'd like another motion to adjourn.
Second.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Aye.